Metro Vancouver team is headed into the Coquitlam Water Supply Area to assess the last glacier in the region, the Coquitlam Glacier. The team is led by Dave Dunkley, a geoscientist with Metro Vancouver who has been studying the Coquitlam Glacier for over 15 years.
The first time I saw the glacier was in 2005 from a helicopter, and I went, whoa, we've got to have a look at that. And I came here first in 2006 for just about an hour. The ice was up halfway up this slope on the left here and on the right here, and it's probably over my head where I'm standing.
A glacier's changes in length, height, and width over time are one of the clearest indicators of environmental shifts due to climate change.
As it warms up, our snowpacks are getting less deep and they're melting, and the snow line is going to move up in elevation.
Metro Vancouver placed a time-lapse camera to monitor the glacier between July and October of 2021. These images show the seasonal snow on top of the glacier melting. The glacier's actual melt is much slower and happens over decades. Dave Dunkley has noticed significant changes in recent years.
When we were here 2 years ago, I had noticed a crevice on the glacier that seemed to be breaking off or calving off from the main glacier up here. It's official now. It's pretty clear that this is getting wider, this crevice, this crack, and it's about a half a meter across. And it looks to be 20 meters down, and you can see water flowing, and it's just an underglacier little creek that's flowing out of here. So it's quite stunning, quite spectacular.
While the glacier does not play a significant role in providing water for the region, the pace at which it is melting illustrates the changes occurring in our water supply area due to climate change. Understanding these changes is essential to ensure continued, reliable, and sustainable delivery of high-quality drinking water to the region.
It's an iconic symbol, and it's important to study this, and that's what we're doing at Metro Vancouver.